Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, that's right. I just want to thank you for coming out on this Memorial Weekend and supporting these people that we've heard today for twice, two performances already, so they are really stoked to have this last concert. I thought if I wore the shirt, they would let me play. That ain't happening. They have had just a remarkable day, and I think, I don't need to say anything, just their sheer talent and their energy on stage is going to be proof enough that they love what they're doing, and I love watching them do what they do. So, without further ado, Flock of Mages.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight you will bear witness to the 2014 Rock of Ages concert headlined by Flock of Mages. You'll listen to charts from the early 1950s to the present, you will take a musical journey and relieve the nostalgia of your youth and live the rock and roll you grew up with. Let's get back to where it all started. Hey, cool cats and daddy-os. The 50s was a rockin', hip, and solid era. The 50s might have been a blast, but there were major areas of conflict. Communism was fresh and ripe, the civil rights movement was booming, and the Cold War brought a great chill to many. Elvis practically defined the 50s by making girls swoon over his flailing hips and legs, and soon became the king of rock and roll. Chuck Berry, Jerry Lee Lewis, and Buddy Holly all helped the rock and roll movement bloom into the decades of great music we have today. Little Richard became an instant success with his hit Tutti Frutti and pounding rhythm and blues style. We'll begin our show with a song that started it all, Rock Around the Clock by Bill Haley and the Comets, a song that was featured in the movie Blackboard Jungle. The opening number will be followed by Chuck Berry's Johnny B. Goode. The lyric country boy was actually colored boy until Berry changed it to get radio time. The song was also covered by Jimi Hendrix. Let us razz your berries with our renditions.
Yeah.
Killer organ playing. American rock and roll was being challenged. The Animals had their first number one hit in England and in America in 1964. As the decade went on, Bob Dylan continued with the folk revolution started by Woody Guthrie and Pete Seeger. The genre included such acts as the Mamas and the Papas, Peter, Paul and Mary, and the Kingston Trio. The Byrds and Bob Dylan are later given credit for leading the way for country rock. With underlying themes of peace, war, and drugs, rock and roll took a drastic turn. With the wide use of distortion, rock and roll became much grittier and dirtier sounding. Female vocalists were also rising up. Janis Joplin started the revolution for female artists to come. When she was younger, Janis Joplin was a soprano singer, but when she got older, her habits broke down her body and her vocal cords. She developed a very gritty sound. Tonight we'll be performing the songs House of the Rising Sun by the Animals and Janis Joplin's Peace of My Heart. decade of the 60s was about change. John F. Kennedy was assassinated in 63. The first artificial heart was put into a human, and Martin Luther King gave his famous I Had a Dream speech in 1963. Things were rapidly changing, including the way we viewed music. Although the Beatles were the dominant band of the 60s, there were other noteworthy bands that took part in ruling the music decade. The Rolling Stones hit the scene with a cover of Chuck Berry's Come On. The Beach Boys also came around with their first single, Surfin', and The Who also showed up with their first single, I Can't Explain. Although these artists played a part in the music era, the Beatles are the most well-known of all the acts. With their earlier songs, P.S. I Love You, and their cover of the Isley Brothers song, Twist and Shout, they began topping the charts. Five of their songs seemingly made their way to the top five quite often. Along the lines of their career, they soon began to experiment with their songs by using feedback, adding unusual instruments, and creating unimaginable sounds and lyrics. Although they broke up in the 1970s, the Beatles will go down in history as the greatest band. You will now hear one of their classics, Come Together.
Thank you.
formed in Hawthorne, California by brothers Brian, Dennis, and Carl Wilson in 1961 and signed to Capitol Records in 1962, the popularity of the surf rock group, the Beach Boys, was spread through the close vocal harmonies, creative ambition, and lyricism evolving around the Southern California culture of surfing, romance, and cars. In 1966, the Beach Boys established themselves as America's first best rock band with the release of their album, Pet Sounds. Despite their financial struggles and their difficulty and eventual failure of recovering their success, the Beach Boys' intricate, multi-layered sound is something that is still celebrated today. Please enjoy their hit single, Surf and Safari. Many of the members will be playing a variety of instruments as well as singing. We have worked hard to present this show. I'd like to introduce our band to you. Chris Floyd. Cameron Curtis. Chad Bia. Amanda LaVertier. Cal Melcher. Matthew Dyke, Angelina Couturier, Austin Payne, Jillian Bia, and your MC for tonight, Evan Hildebrand. We hope you enjoy the rest of the show. With each new decade comes more change. Different kinds of music becoming more popular, genres including jazz rock, folk rock, soft rock, R&B, and heavy metal, along with the Motown sound. Leading the way in heavy metal was Led Zeppelin and Black Sabbath. Even though great things were taking shape in these styles of rock, the world was mourning the loss of the Beatles. The role of women in America was changing as well. The Equal Rights Movement was making great strides. Female artists were taking full advantage of this new feminist view, led by such greats as Janis Joplin and Grace Slick. The Motown sound included groups such as The Temptations, The Supremes, Marvin Gaye, The Jackson 5, and Stevie Wonder. To showcase the many varieties of rock during this period, we're performing one of Stevie Wonder's hits, Signed, Sealed, Delivered, followed by Joe Walsh's Rocky Mountain Way, and wrapping up the decade with a female-led group of Heart, with our cover of Crazy on You.
Yeah, Julia!
Thank you. Oh,
exciting decade for music. Hair bands were big, and the long, complicated guitar solos became the start of the new metal bands. The decade was the start of MTV, an entire television station that was dedicated to the videos in order to promote songs with the current artists, no matter the genre. The 80s were also the decade of the yuppies, fondly known as the baby boomers, with a college degree who lived in wealthy suburbs and could support expensive taste. How many colleges did you wear in high school? The 80s rocked with heavy metal bands and pop. Some of the biggest artists were Michael Jackson, Guns N' Roses, Journey, and The Police. Guns N' Roses was a hard rock heavy metal band that formed in Los Angeles, California in 1985. They fit in with the party style and liked to headbang until they dropped. The 80s also saw a rise in female rockers. Fashioned after such singers as Janis Joplin and Grace Slick, these women are ready to front the band. Pat Benatar, Stevie Nicks, and Joan Jett are among the decade-leading ladies. Our band has put together a cover version of Sweet Child of Mine by Guns N' Roses and I Love Rock and Roll by Joan Jett. These songs are a true reflection of 80s music.
I'm not.
punk and rap, these genres started to make inroads to a wider listening audience. Because the majority of rap songs are littered with dark themes and inappropriate language, we've chosen not to represent this genre tonight. Miss Fennelson doesn't let us swear. Kurt Cobain hailed all that was alternative. The decade was filled with rock gods everywhere. Lane Staley wailed his perfect pitches with Alice in Chains, Billy Joe Armstrong when Green Day was in its prime, and Blink-182 was a hit with the drummer Travis Barker. The 90s definition of the Big Three is Chris Novoselic, Dave Grohl, and Kurt Cobain. Nirvana led the way for the alternative rock bands to follow. Blasting on the stage in 1987, the band made a great impact in the brief 7 years before Cobain's unfortunate death. In those 7 years, the band released 3 full-length albums and had numerous hit singles. Dave Grohl later became a member of the Foo Fighters and was often featured with other bands. Tonight we will perform Nirvana's hit, Come As You Are. Creed, Matchbox 20, Switchfoot, and Seether all had considerable success during the time period. They took an anthem narrative approach to songs and mixed them with less angry lyrics, many of which could be thought-provoking. The War on Terror was declared during this decade after 9/11, an event that devastated the hearts of millions of Americans. America would never be the same, nor would the music. The decade was full of push-pull and love and hate, but all those feelings came together to produce a more sustainable future with a more distinguished style of music. We will perform Joke from the Thief by Wolf Mother and That's What You Get by Paramore.
Thank you.
Five Finger Death Punch, Avenged Sevenfold, and Stone Sour lay down the heavy riffs and hard drums. The punk pop style can give comeback rights to the more notable groups such as Blink-182 and Paramore. As the decade goes on, the genres being introduced are expanding and will continue to evolve, being influenced by the music of every preceding decade. Our song selected representing the 2010s, Post-Acid by Waves and Tired by Stone Sour. We'd like to thank you for all coming, and we hope you've enjoyed the show.
Stay. That I just have Yeah.